Okay, so we are discussing about the attributes, isn't it? Okay, so last attribute it is transpose. Okay, what is transpose? How we can find out the transpose? And Jo Anthony, switch on the video. Grishma, how we can find out the transpose of a data frame? Grishma,
the rows become columns and columns become rows.
Okay, correct, Grishma. It is rows are converted to columns and columns are converted to rows. That is transpose. Okay, in maths I think in the smaller classes you learn about this transpose in matrix, same as that. Okay. Okay, Anthony. Okay, so that is last attribute, it is transpose. Transpose is used to convert a row into column and column into row. Okay, I will give some questions based on one data frame, data structure. I will first write this data frame, data structure. Roll number, total, percentage. Then here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the, and first column value 6 values, second column value 6 values, last column value 6 values. First you draw the table and write the content. And Joe Vidur, switch on the video. And Joe. And Joe, am I audible, And Joe?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What happened to your video camera? Completed. Meghna. Okay. Adi, draw this table fast. Irfan, draw this table. Roll number, total, percentage. Then here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and some values inside each column. All of you switch on the video. All of you switch on the video. Ashish, Irfan, Amal, switch on the video. Irfan, Amal, switch on the video. Hadi, switch on the video. Okay, write the first question. Print df dot index. Print df dot index. Df dot index. Write the result. Print df dot index. Hanna, what is the use of index attribute?
It is used to display the row name.
Yes, correct, Hanna. It is used to display the row name. Index is the alternate name for row name. So, index attribute is used to display the row name. Then Vidur, read the answer.
Index open bracket round bracket then square bracket 1 2 3 4 5 6
index open bracket within square bracket 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 then
close bracket then D type int 64
D type it is int 64 close the open bracket. Correct, Vidur. So, here I is capital index. For attribute index, we are using small letter INDX. Okay. But in the output section, index is represented like this. Capital INDEX. Index. These cases are important in Python. Okay. And based on your MCQ exam also, these cases are very important. Okay, so in the case of index attribute, we are using capital letter index attribute. We are using df dot index index. Okay, but in the case of output window, the output is displayed like this. Capital letter INDEX within round bracket. First write the index names. Here the index names are. Here, this is the index name. Index name is also known as row name. Okay. Index names are also known as row names. So, here the row names are the first row name it is 1, second row name it is 2, third it is 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. So, these are the, there is no difference here. Okay. This is. The value under this 6 is value under this roll number. Okay, so this is the row name or index name. So if you are using df dot index, the output is I is capital index, I index within round bracket, within square bracket, write this index names within square bracket 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then close the square bracket. Write a comma after that D type. You write the D type of this row name. Here we are using integer values. So the row name it is integer. So D type it is int 64. Is it clear, Hadi? Hadi?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Then write the second statement. Print df dot columns. Df dot columns. Ashish, what is the meaning of column attribute? Columns attribute?
To display name of the column.
Yes, correct, Ashish. Columns attribute is used to display the names of the columns. Anthony, read the result. Anthony? Okay, Irfan, read the result. Irfan, am I audible, Irfan? Irfan, are you there? Okay, Elvina, read the result.
Index. Round bracket, square bracket, roll number, total, percentage. Close the square bracket, comma, D type. Object.
How we can represent this roll number, total, percentage? Elvina? I'm writing the statement like this. Any error is there, Elvina? In my statement? Anyone?
Quotes.
You want to represent this roll number within single quotes or within double quotes, because these all are strings, because we are writing the D type as object. Object means what? That is set of strings, set of characters. Okay, so here if I am writing a value like this, 5, there is no need of single quotes. But here I am using roll number. Roll number is a set of alphabets. So it is a string. String can be represented only using the single quotes or double quotes. Okay. So that is the error in this statement. So write roll number within single quotes or double quotes, total within single quotes, percentage within single quotes. Then after comma, write the D type also. Okay. Is it clear? Amal? Is it clear? Okay, so that is columns attribute. Then write the axis, print df.axis. df.axis, A-X-E-S. Amal, what is the meaning of axis attribute? You just check it in the notebook. Today you can, exam days you can use notebook for answering. What is the use of access? No idea, Mal? Meghna?
Both column and row.
For both column name and row name, we are using axis. For row name, we are using index. For column name, we are using columns attribute. And for both row and column name, we are using axis attribute. Okay. So print df.axis. Amal? Is it clear, Amal? Okay. Then read the result. And you read the result.
Index. Round bracket and square bracket. One comma two.
2, 6. Okay. Then.
Then square bracket.
No, we want to write the D type also. D type of row. What is the D type of row name? It is int 64. Okay. First, write the row name, comma, type of row name. After that, you can write the column name. Okay. Close this bracket. After that, index. Continue, Anjo.
Round bracket, square bracket, roll number, total.
How we can represent roll number, Anjo?
Single quotes.
Within single quotes, okay. Total, then percentage. Then close the square bracket. After that, Anjo?
D type.
What is the D type here? Which one? It is object. Okay. It is object because here we are using string. If the content is string, the D type it is object. Okay. Is it clear, Anjo?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then all of you switch on the video. Then find the error in this statement. One error is there. Meghna, what is the error? Identify the error in this output. Is it correct?
Bracket.
Which bracket? Where it is needed?
First in index and last after object.
Which bracket is needed?
Square.
Yes, here we need a square bracket. Okay, that is the error in this output section. Okay, these are some questions included in our term exam. Okay, so the output is the access attribute is used to display row name and column name. Okay, for that, first we represent the row name with D type, just like our index. Okay, that is first I will write index, then within round bracket, within square bracket, write the row name, then D type in 64. Comma, write index, that is for representing column headings. D type object. Then these two values are enclosed within square bracket. Okay. This row name and column names are within square bracket. Okay, is it clear? Okay, then write the next one. It is print df dot d types. Print df dot d types. Print df dot d types.
And what?
D types. Df dot d types. Df is the data frame name. D types. Right now, what is the use of D-types? D-types attributes? It's not clear, Raina. Your mic is.
To find the data types or the value.
Data types of each column value. Okay. Here we are using so many values. So data D types is used to display the data types of each column. Mention that point, each column, to represent each column value, not the row. It is used to represent the data type of each column. Lydia, read the result. Miss Lydia. Okay. Grishma, read the result.
Roll number in 64.
Roll number. This in 64. Then
total float 64.
Total float 64.
Percentage in 64.
Percentage in 64. One more output is there. That is D type. Okay. D type, we consider it as object, because here we are using data types. That data type include character and number. So we consider this as object. Okay. For D types, first write the column name. In roll number, column name, we are using only whole numbers. There is no point value. So this is for integer representation. So roll number is in 64. Here we are using a number with fractional part, 0.0, 0.5, 0.0. So this is the data type used. It is float 64, because here we are using floating point value, pointed value. So total its data type, it is float 64. In the case of percentage, we are using whole numbers. There is no point here, so it is in 64. Then we want to write the D type of this one. What is the D type of these values? Here we are using character and number. Here also character is there. Here also character is there. So we consider this as string. So the D type, it is object. Okay, in all the situations, in the case of D types attribute, the D type, it is object. Okay, because we are using the data types like in 64, float 64, bool, just like that. Okay, all these data types are including alphabets. So it is a set of strings. So we write D type as object. Okay, note this point also. Okay. After writing all the data types of each column, write the whole data type of this data structure. That is D type, it is object. This D type is based on these values. Okay. The next, write size, df dot size. Df dot size. Df dot size. Ashish, what is the use of size, Ashish? Size attribute.
To multiplying the number of rows and columns.
number of rows into number of columns. That is to find the total number of elements in the data frame. That is size. Okay. Amal, read the result. Amal. Amal. Read the result, Amal. Here, how many rows are there, Amal?
The total 6 rows into and 3 column.
Yes, that is number of rows. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rows into 1, 2, 3, 3 column. The result is 6 into 3. What is the result, Amal?
18.
Okay. So, size means total number of elements present in the data frame data structure. We can find out this result using the equation number of rows into number of columns. Here, number of rows, it is 6. Number of columns, it is 3. So, 6 into 3, which is equal to 18. Okay. Is it clear, Anthony? Anthony?
Yeah.
Okay. So write the next statement. Print df dot shape. Print df dot shape. Irfan, are you there, Irfan?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. How many times I call you? What is the meaning of shape, Irfan? Shape attribute. You just check it in the notebook, Irfan. What is the purpose of shape attribute?
Indicating the number of elements.
Then what is the use of size? Raina, what is shape, Raina?
No, it returns the shape of an array.
Ah. Then which values are returned? No. Raina?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the meaning of shape attribute?
It also mentions shape. Shape and it gives the number of columns and rows.
Number of rows and columns. Okay. Shape is an attribute that used to display the size. Size in the sense that it is not the total size. It is used to display row number and column name, column number separately. Okay, shape is the attribute used to display row number and column number separately. Okay, so what is the result, Hanna? Here, what is the result?
Six comma three.
Okay, Elvina, identify the error.
Round bracket.
Yes, one round bracket is also needed. Okay, that is in the form of tuple. Okay, tuple. Tuple is represented using round bracket. Okay, so shape is the attribute that is used to display row number and column number separately. Is it clear, Irfan?
Yes.
Okay, then it is represented within round bracket. Okay. First one, it is the row number, and second one, it is the column number. Okay. Then write the next statement. It is endim. Print df dot endim. Hadi, what is the use of endim, Hadi?
Number of dimensions.
Yes, yes. So here, what is the dimension, Hadi?
2.
Yes, correct, Hadi. So and dim and data frame data structure, the result is 2 because it is a 2D data structure, two dimensional data structure. So the end dim value, it is 2. Okay. Then next one, it is empty. Print df dot empty. Print df dot empty. Sana, what is the result, Sana? Sana?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the use of empty attribute, Sana? Empty attribute.
It gives the output in the form of true or false.
Ah, yes. Then, how in the case of print df dot empty, what is the result, Sana? Is it true or false?
True.
No, it is false because empty is a function or it is an attribute that is used to check whether that df is empty or not. Okay. Empty is the attribute that is used to check if this df is empty or not. If it is empty, then the result is true. Here, is it empty? This df is empty. Sana?
No, ma'am.
No, some contents are there. Okay, so the result, it is false. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so empty is the attribute that is used to check. All of you switch on the video. Okay, empty is the attribute that is used to check if that data frame is empty or not. It will return Boolean values as result, that is either true or false. That is the result. True means there is nothing in this data frame data structure. If this df is empty, then the result is true. All these values are deleted, then the result is true. But here now some values are there in this df. Okay, so df dot empty is false. It is not empty. So the result is false. If it is empty, then the result is true. Here it includes some value, so the result is false. Clear? Okay, any doubt related with this empty? No. Okay, then write the next one. Count. Df dot print, df dot count, print df dot count, print df dot count 1, print df dot count 0. Do it fast. Print df dot count, print df dot count 1, print df dot count 0. All of you switch on the video. Sana, Anjo, Hadi, Irfan, Ashish, switch on the video. Hadi, how was the exam, Hadi? Is it easy?
It is okay, ma'am.
Okay. Anjo, Sana, Irfan, Anthony, switch on the video. Sana and Anjo, switch on the video. Okay. What is the meaning of count? Anthony, what is the meaning of count, Anthony?
Count of rows along with row numbers.
Count is used to? Once again, Anthony.
Count the rows along with row numbers.
Roll number. Okay. Count is used to display rows along with column name. Okay. Here the column name, it is roll number. Then how many rows are columns rows are there in? So first it will appear like this. First column name, it is roll number. How many rows are there in this roll number? Anjo? Count is used to, what Anjo? Six, correct Anjo. Count is used to display number of rows along number of rows of each column. Count is used to count the number of rows in each column. So first I will write the first column name, it is roll number. Then how many rows are there? Six rows are there. So the answer, it is six. Then write the second column heading, it is total. Here also six rows are there, so six. The last one, it is percentage. Here also six rows. Okay, Reina, what about the second one, Reina? If it is count one. Count one, you're absent in the previous class, isn't it? Okay. Grishma? Count one, it is? One, three. Okay, Grishma, correct. 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6, 3. That is, count one is used to count the number of columns present in each row. Number of columns present in each row. That means, take the first row. That is one. In one, how many columns are there? One, two, three. Three columns are there. So write three. Then take the second row. That is two. How many columns are there in second row? One, two, three. So write three. Just like that. In all rows, it include three columns. Okay. So first row, that is name, it is one. Number of columns, it is three. Two, number of columns, it is three. 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, and 6, 3. Okay. The last question, it is df.transpose. Print df.transpose. What is transpose? Columns are converted to row, rows are converted to column. So first write roll number, total, percentage. Then it is all the values under this column. This column values are converted to row value. So I will write this column values as row value. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then this total column values are converted to row value. So 350.5, 400.0, 420.0, 356.0, 434.0, 398.0. Then what about this last value? That is percentage. And this percentage row, 70 is the first value, 80, 84, 80, 87 and 79. And write the headings, that is row headings, as row headings are converted to column headings. Column headings are converted to row headings. Row headings are converted to column headings. So here the column headings are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is the output of which one? Transpose attribute. Okay. Is it clear? Any doubt related with attributes? Any attribute? Any doubt? No. Okay. Anjo present, Adul Krishna absent, Basil absent, Hanna present, Rufan, Pavitra absent, Sharat absent, okay, Hadi present, Donna absent, Evelyn absent, Lydia also absent. Minachi absent, Nevin absent, Anthony present, Vidur present, Amal Raj present, Amal K. Saji absent, Ashish present, Elvina present, Grishma, Raina, Sana, okay, Sana, Sneha absent, Meghna present. Okay, let us wind up the session, continue in the next class, okay? Bye.